everyone, welcome back. And this is Naveen from UiBrains. So in this video, we are going to discuss about what is JavaScript. So the very first question is, what is JavaScript? So what is JavaScript? So JavaScript is a programming language, okay? So JavaScript is a programming language. So what exactly the programming language? So let me clear. We all know the language, right? So we have a different languages, like we have Telugu, Hindi, English, Marathi, and French, Chinese, Japanese, and all. So why these languages? Just forget about programming language. So what this language means? A language which is used as a communication between two persons. If two persons want to interact with each other and they want to share the knowledge between each other and they want to command the other person, you have to know a common language between them, right? Same way, we have programming language. There are multiple programming languages, right? So what is programming languages? So programming language is not to communicate with a person to person. And the programming language is actually made to interact with the underlying hardware or the systems or the computers. Okay, so as a human, we are going to use our programming language, and with that, we are going to interact with the system. It means we have to go, we have to write some set of commands and instructions in that programming language, and based on that programming language instructions, the system is going to work. Okay, so generally, what is the similarity between every programming language? We have different programming languages like Java, .NET, PHP, Python, R language like JavaScript and all. So what is the similarity between all the programming languages is, for every programming language, the two things are common. The very first thing is, one is the programming concepts or the rules. And the second one is runtime environments. So if you take any programming language, two things are very common for every programming language. If you take Java, .NET, PHP, whatever, two things common. One is programming concepts or the rules, and the runtime environment. So what is program concepts and rules is, so when a language is developed, so if you want to write some instructions, actually the main goal of a programmer or the developer is he has to write some programs. So how you write a programs is based on the language concepts or the rules on the program. It means how to create a variable, how to create data types, functions, objects, arrays, some different data structures. So all these are concepts and rules, and how to create a variable and how to declare a data type, how to create a function. These are all rules and concepts. So what is the major role of a programmer is, he has to use these programming concepts, okay? And then he has to write a program. And why he has to write a program is, every programming language like these two concepts, environments and concepts. So as a programmer, he has to develop a program because he want to do a commands. Actually, programming language is for give some instruction to the system, right? If you want to give instruction to the system, in which way you can give an instruction to the system is using a program. So a developer can take the concepts or the rules of programming language, and based on those rules and the concepts, he will write a nice program. Okay, based on his requirement, he will write a program, all the set of instructions he writes. And all these set of instructions, how can you hand over to the system to execute them is, every system will have the underlying operating system, will have the runtime environment. It means, so this is actually the brain or the engine of your application, okay? So it means, if you are giving some instruction to the system, so who can understand your instructions and act accordingly is, every system will have a runtime environment. It's one again a software, so which understand your program, and it will convince your instruction to the system, and then system will start working based on your instruction given in the program. So that's how every programming language works. If you take a language called Java, Java is having a runtime environment called JRE. So Java runtime environment, it is one software. So it is going to understand your Java program and it is conveying the message to the underlying system. The same way we have JavaScript. So JavaScript, the runtime environment is going to be the browser. Okay, so JavaScript runtime environment is going to be the browser. So if you are if you want to execute any JavaScript program, what you have to do is you have to execute on a browser. So what browser can do is each browser internally will have a JavaScript engine. So what is this JavaScript engine is going to do is, which is going to understand all your instructions which you have given the JavaScript program, and all these instructions can be can be converted as a direct instruction to the browser, and the processing logic what you have written, the output is going to display on a browser. So mostly the JavaScript we are going to run on a browser, because JavaScript mostly is used for client side applications. Okay, so that is the concept of a programming language and even JavaScript. So in the next video we are going to discuss about what are the advantages of JavaScript. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll meet in the next video. Thank you.